So what we're seeing, we're at the University of Pittsburgh Center for Vaccine Research. This is the same place where Dr. Salk developed and produced the polio vaccine back in the 1950s, and they've done an amazing work here at getting vaccines throughout the decades since. They're specifically working on the coronavirus vaccine right now. They're one of the centers working on it, and it's a race against time, essentially, because now we know it's out of containment. It's more in a mitigation process, and part of that mitigation means getting a vaccine to try and help everybody out. That's what we do with the flu. We can't contain it, so we try to mitigate it. We try to help out as best we can. Now, it's going to take about a year, year and a half, but they're really doing incredible work here to try and get that as short as possible, but it does take some time, and that's one of the things we've learned as we come here. This is a very highly secure lab. Again, they have a lot of different viruses here they're dealing with. Some of those create illnesses, some of those cause death, but it's very specific how you go in there, and they've given us some exclusive access to there to be able to see what they're doing and see how they're working. It's pretty amazing what they're doing.
Hey, Dr. Torres, could I put one of our audience questions to you, actually, because since you are at this lab that's doing this research, it gets to one of the questions in terms of the intensity with which we're dealing with coronavirus. One of our viewers asked, if flu results in over 50,000 deaths a year in the U.S. alone, why is so much commotion being created with coronavirus, where deaths are significantly lower than the normal flu?
And I thought Dr. Fauci said it appropriately the other day when he said, here's the deal, flu, the mortality rate, the fatality rate of flu is about 0.1%. This one looks around 1%, so it's 10 times higher. It hasn't spread quite as much throughout the world as the flu typically does, but it's only been around for a couple of months. You can imagine if we didn't do anything about it and it had 10 times the fatality rate, it could cause a lot more issues. But that's why they're putting so much effort around the world and in the U.S. as well to try and keep it under control. It's gotten through that containment. We're trying to mitigate now. But the important part is to keep making that effort, because if we don't, it could actually prove deadlier than the flu as far as numbers are concerned. We know it's already deadlier than the flu as far as the amount of fatality, the rate of fatality. We're trying to keep those overall numbers as low as we can, though.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.